Hello everybody, welcome back to the e-learning space for MGM Higher Secondary School Bokaro. I am Mrs. Sadaf Nuri and this is the second video for Unit 3, Section B from the English course book for Class 8. The lesson that we are dealing with is titled Boating with Friends, written by Jerome K. Jerome. Let us go through the summary of the story. In the previous video, we have read the story and discussed it in detail. The story begins with three men in a boat, namely Jerome, George, and Harry. It is 6 a.m. in the morning. They are on the River Thames. River Thames is in England. George and Jerome are already up and have been talking for the past 1 hour. Harry is still fast asleep. They wake him up. They had decided to take a swim in the morning river water. However, all the three friends do not seem to be as excited as when they were making the decision about swimming last night. George and Harry give up the idea. Their actions speak louder than the words. They start dressing up for the day. However, Jerome decides to at least dip his feet in the water. Since it was his idea, he did not want to look like a coward. He sits on the branch of a tree overhanging the river. The cold water dissuades him and now he gets up to leave, but the branch breaks and he falls into the chilly water. This makes him a laughing stock. His friends, especially George, is unable to stop laughing at his misadventure. Jerome feels very, very bitter at his friend. In a hurry to get dressed, his shirt falls into the river. This makes George laugh even harder. Jerome realizes that the shirt that fell into the river was actually George's. So now it is his turn to laugh at his friend. However, George does not appreciate the humor and gets angry at his friend, Jerome, and calls him worthless. Harry finds all of this amusing. Coming to the elements in the story, let us first begin with the title. As we know, the title of the story, Boating with Friends, is about three friends, Jerome, George, and Harry, who plan an adventure. They plan to take a boat to the River Thames and spend some good time together as friends. Characters. There are three characters mentioned here, and this given short story is an edited extract from the Jerome's famous work, Three Men in a Boat. In this story, there are three mentioned characters, Jerome, George, and Harry. What is the setting of the story? The story is set in a boat on the River Thames, England. It's a cold morning in England at 6 a.m. Some part of the story describe the banks of the river and also the cold water of the Thames. Let us discuss the theme or the themes involved in the story, Boating with Friends. From the title itself, which is very clear, that Jerome has used the friendship and camaraderie between three friends, George, Jerome, and Harry, as the theme of his story. And another theme explored by the author is adventure. The boating with friends in the River Thames is an adventure that the three friends are going to undertake in the story. Fun and laughter. The entire story is replete with words like peals of laughter, sniggering, guffawed, etc. It is a light-hearted story of fun and laughter that takes place when friends are together. Humor and comedy. As we know, the story is taken from Unit 3, which is all about humor and comedy. Keeping to the unit and its theme, the story has a comic and humorous tone. The incidents are described are relatively funny. Let us discuss the plots and the subplot. Jerome K. Jerome develops the plot of friendship, fun, and humor in the story Boating with Friends. Jerome, George, and Harry are spending some time on a boat in the River Thames. They have a good time catching up and sharing stories. They decide to take a plunge in the river on a cold morning. Harry and George chicken out of the deal. Chicken out means to not act on it out of cowardice. The climax is reached when Jerome falls into the water unintentionally and his friends make fun of him. The conflict takes place when the situation is reversed and it is time for George to be laughed at. The conclusion of the story is reached when George is unable to take the fun poked at him in a good stride. Now Jerome ends up subtly preaching, this is the subplot, do to others as you would have others do to you. That is the end line of the story as well as the moral of the lesson. And it's very subtle, it is not very didactic in tone, but with the help of humor and comic relief, the author is able to put the message across. Let us come to the textual exercises from pages 53 to 58. First exercise about the passage, read to understand. Answer these questions with reference to the context. First one, I didn't think he'd have the pluck to do it, did you? Identify the speaker and the listener. So the speaker here, as we know, is Harry. And the listener is George, but Jerome also overhears it. Who is the he referred here? He is the person who unintentionally took a plunge into the river, which is Jerome. What did he have the pluck to do? Have the pluck means courage. He had the pluck to take a dive into the cold morning water of the Thames. What does this reveal about the speaker's opinion? This shows that first of all, Harry did not believe that Jerome was brave enough to take the plunge, so the tone is of disbelief. What a heartless maniac you are, the second one. Whose words are these? These are the words of Jerome, who fell into the river and is trying to dry himself up and get some warm clothes. To whom are they spoken? These are spoken to George because he was laughing at his situation. Why is the person being called a heartless maniac? So here we are going to discuss why he is being called a heartless maniac, because he is a friend of Jerome and he is supposed to help him out when he is shivering in the cold and trying to get a shirt on, but instead he is laughing at his situation, and especially when the shirt falls into the river, he makes fun of him. What are the speakers feeling at this moment? Of course, Jerome is actually very angry with his friend George, so his feelings are that of anger. What does the speaker do shortly after saying this? After saying this to George, he tries to haul the shirt out of the river with the help of a boating hook or boat hook. Coming to the second part, answer these questions. Where were the three friends and what time of day was it? The three friends were on a boat on River Thames and it is early morning. Why do you think Jerome and George shared some not so true stories? When friends get to talking, in order to pretend that they have had a very adventurous life or they are very heroic, they tend to share stories that are not true in order to come as the braver person among the two. What had the three planned to do the previous night? The previous night, they got to talking and they had planned that they will get up early in the morning, fling their blankets and take a good swim in the cold water of the River Thames. What motivated Jerome to pretend to be brave? Jerome's idea was to jump into the river and take a swim early morning. So he had to pretend to be brave because he did not want to become a laughing stock. And he wanted to prove that his idea was not silly, was not stupid. And he did not want to come as a coward person. What did George find very funny? When Jerome accidentally fell into the water, when the branch broke, it made him the laughing stock and George found it very funny. Especially when he was trying to get dressed and his shirt fell into the river, it made George laugh even harder. What was the precious moment? Okay, precious moment here is the time when Jerome quickly realizes that the shirt which fell into the river is not actually his shirt, it belongs to George. And that made him laugh because George was laughing at his own shirt being dumped into the river. That was a moment which Jerome found precious. What did Harry find really amusing? Harry, the third friend, is quite amused that when it was George's turn to be laughed at, he actually becomes offended and is angry at Jerome. So the whole situation is amusing to Harry. Then the page, discuss and write. What kind of personality did George display? Give examples to support your opinion. So George is a kind of person who likes to poke fun at others but wouldn't be laughed at if the tables are turned. So we can call him a hypocrite. And also he is a coward because they have together decided to jump into the river and take a swim. However, he starts wearing his socks and clearly portrays or shows through his actions that he is not interested in taking the plunge. So he is a coward and a hypocrite. And also a person who is not helping his friend at the time of his need. Who would you say is the most balanced person of the three? Give reasons. I would think it's Harry, but of course it is a subjective answer. So you can, if you choose any of the three friends, you will have to give your reasons. I think Harry is the more balanced person because he is not either poking too much fun at George, not too much fun at Jerome. And he is the one person who thinks that it is better to get dressed and get started for the day instead of being a mindless person and taking a jump into the cold river water of the Thames in the early morning. He has nothing to prove. He is not afraid of his friends jeering at him for not keeping his words. Let us come to expand words. Look at these sentences. Give me the boat hook. Hook it to the boat. Here the word hook is used both as a noun and as a verb. Some words can function as different parts of speech depending on the context. I have told this earlier while teaching grammar. Whenever you use a word, you have to make sure in which context it is using, and that decides which part of speech it belongs to. So in this exercise, write the part of speech of the highlighted words and use them in sentences of your own. First one, it is time to water the plants. Water here is an action. So it is a verb. So you'll have to point out and then you have to make your own sentence using water as a verb. Second one, Jerome fell into the water with a splash. Here the water is a noun, name of a thing. So again, you're going to make a sentence as with water as a noun. Similarly, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, you're going to do it on your own and make sentences and do this in your classwork copy. The water was freezing cold there. Her feet were freezing. The clock in the cabin showed 6 in the morning. She clocked 8 seconds in the final race. The wind cut like a knife. The cut on his arm looked painful. So you have to decide what parts of speech these words are and then turn them into sentences of your own. Coming to say it right, some words can have a very different meaning with a small change in the vowel or the consonant sound. For example, lovely, Jerome spluttered back, speaking quickly with spitting sounds. Spluttered here means speaking quickly with spitting sounds. The heavy rain splattered on the roof of the boat. Noisy sound of drops of a liquid falling on or hitting something. Just with the changing of U and A, the two vowels, we can easily change the complete meaning of these words. So here are a list of few words. You have to listen to them carefully and use them in your own sentences later. Please find out the meanings of these pair of words and write it down in your books itself. Affect, effect, adverse, averse, flaunt, flout, bizarre, bizarre, censure, censor, expensive, expansive. So now, here are certain sentences. You have to read it aloud, and if you have pronounced it correctly, you just have to make a tick mark. I have just pronounced these words for you. This land is very expensive. This land is very expensive. So expensive here means, in the first sentence, something that is highly priced. And expansive in the second part of the first sentence means something that is huge in size, widespread. You have few more sentences here. She flaunted a new pair of earrings. She flouted all the rules to go there. Please find out the meaning of these set of words and note them down in your textbook. Pollution badly affects the environment. Pollution has a bad effect on the environment. They went to the bazaar in the evening. They went to a really bizarre restaurant last week. Schools have closed due to adverse weather. Schools are averse to closing down for the sudden holiday. The restaurant was censured for being unhygienic. The channel censored some of the dialogues in the film. You just have to practice pronunciation and note down the meanings of these set of words. Let us now come to the grammar part, subject-verb agreement. In our grammar video about verbs and subject-verb agreement, we have already learnt the rules. Now it is the time to test our previous knowledge. So here are certain sentences. Read them. Understand whether they are correct grammatically. If they are correct, put a tick mark. If they are wrong, rewrite them in the book itself. Please accept our invitation. No, we are talking to a second person. So, please accept our invitation. So, put a cross mark and correct the sentence in the book itself. The chairs are very comfortable. This is correct. Does he knows about the picnic? This is wrong. Does he know about the picnic? He is third person singular. The person you describe live here. The person you describe mean person is singular. So, it will be describe lives here. S. Gymnastics are not popular in my school. Gymnastics are not popular in my school. My village don't have community center. Please make sure that if the subject is singular, what would be the verb? Will it have S, ES, or would it not have it? That is the trick. Neither the doctor nor the patients was seen. Aren't the news about his award very exciting? So I leave these four sentences for you to do it. There is one error in each line of this passage. Underline the error and write the correct word in the blank beside the line. So once again, I'll not discuss everything. I'll leave something for you to do. These are like practice worksheets depending on how much you have retained from the grammar videos. If you have any confusion, we are going to discuss it in the online classes. Floods is a common natural disaster. Floods is plural and is singular. So we better write floods are a common natural disaster. So underline is, and over here in the blank just write are. Scientists has often tried to predict floods. No, scientists is plural. So has is for used for singular. So we have to change that has into have. Scientists have often tried to predict floods. There is a number of reasons that. No. If there are number of reasons, then it has to be plural and is over here is used for singular. There are a number of reasons that causes flood or that cause floods, including heavy rain and cloud bursts. So next four sentences, you're going to do it on your own. If you have any confusion, you can refer to the grammar video on verbs and discuss it in the online classes. Coming to transitive and intransitive verbs. Once again, we have already done this in the grammar video for verbs, but here are some words which can be used both transitively and intransitively. You are supposed to use them in sentences of your own. Deliver, connect, pour, watch, start, Read. You have learnt that an intransitive verb can express a complete thought without the help of other words. For example, wood burns, birds fly, mosquitoes bite. So using these verbs, the sentence is complete and they do not need more words to complete its meaning. So these words are called verbs of complete predication. Means the verbs in these sentences make the sentence complete. Now read these examples. George seemed. The boat is. Now these highlighted words, they do not express a complete thought. The verbs here need other words to complete their meaning. They are called verbs of incomplete predication. The common verbs of incomplete predication are be and its all forms, seem, appear, look, become, feel and grow. For example, George seemed excited. The boat is sailing on the river. So you have to complete these sentences with the help of some predicate. The words thus added to complete the meaning of a verb of incomplete predication are called its complements. Excited is the complement for the verb seemed. Sailing on the river is a complement for the verb is, which is an incomplete predication. Now we come to the non-finite verbs. There are three types of non-finite verbs, infinitives, gerunds and participles. And these three have been dealt in detail in our grammar video on verbs. So basically this is a worksheet for you to test your previous knowledge. I shall help you with a few, but the rest you're going to do on your own in the textbook itself. Let us quickly revise this table. Non-finite verbs, infinitive, gerund, participle. What are its form, function and examples? Infinitive uses to with the verb and it is used as a noun. For example, to make fun of someone is not kind. He tried to pull out his shoes from under the bed. Gerunds use verb with ing and once again they are used as a noun. For example, swimming is a very good exercise. Swimming here becomes the name of an activity, becomes a noun. Coming to participle, you use the verb with ed or ing, but when it is in an ing form, a participle is not used as a noun, but it is a form of a tense or an adjective. For example, the cat was ripping the soft cushion with his sharp claws. The ripped cushion had to be replaced. Fill in the blanks with the two infinitive, gerund or participle forms of the verbs given in brackets. My mother likes to invite people to dinner, so I am inviting my friends tomorrow. I was swimming in the shallow end of the pool, so the coach told me to swim in the deep end. Rest, please do on your own in the book itself. I hope you have got what we are doing here. It's like a practice worksheet for your previous knowledge on verbs. Coming to time to write, this is basically an event which is given, the numbers are mixed up, the flow of the event is not according to the same timeline. What you have to do is you read and understand which event will come first and arrange it chronologically. So you need not rewrite it in the copy, just rearrange the numbers in the book itself. As the head prefect of your school, you have to assist the school coordinator to organize an educational field trip. Rewrite these steps for arranging an outdoor field trip in sequence. Then put the points under two subheads, preparation and on the day of the trip. So you have to find out which events are for preparation before the trip and which events are for on the trip. Arrange for the transport, assign group monitors and give them specific instruction, choose an affordable destination, compile all information in a folder, consent forms, expense receipts, check if students are carrying necessary items, snacks, water, IDs, discuss safety rules to be adhered to, shortlist two or three sites for an educational trip, enjoy the trip, explain what the students will learn from the visit, explain all activities before the trip including what they need to carry, explain behavior or conduct expected, finalize Arrangements for reservation with the site owners or managers, make a list of potential educational sites, obtain permission from parents, select the site for an educational trip, take attendance carefully. So from these 16 sentences, it is very clear which events have to be decided before the trip itself and which events have to be done on the trip. So please arrange it in the book itself, arrange the numbers. Life skills. The story highlights an important aspect of social interaction, which can be summed up in these words. Do to others what you would wish them to do to you. To what extent do you think this is true in real life? So this is a thought you have to ponder upon, that if you do not want somebody to make fun of you, you shouldn't make fun of others. You can only endure what you would do to others. So this is a life lesson that we have learned from this story. Coming to the assignments, these are the assignments that you must do. First of all, read the lesson and learn the difficult words. Then learn the word meanings. Complete all the textual exercises in the textbook. Each and every exercise has been discussed in this video, so I expect you to complete it in the textbook. Coming to page number 53, about the passage, both exercises A and B have to be written in your English copies. Then on page 54, expand the words. That you have to do in your English copy. Two sets of words are there, how they are used, in what parts of speech they are used, you have to understand and use it in your own sentences. After that, you have to give a pictorial representation of the lesson based on what you have understood when I was explaining the lesson. Children, that brings us to the end. We shall do more activities in the online classes related to the chapters and discuss any doubts that you have regarding Boating with Friends by Jerome K. Jerome. We shall meet again in our next video. Till then, thank you everyone and take care.